for the radio silence for the longest time. We have been busy, and we'll summarize everything that's been going on. So there's been like 4 bad things, but we have 8 good things. 8 good things. Okay, so we'll start with the bad. The first bad thing was, okay, Naya, we were at this mall. It was called Galerias. And she like sat down on the escalator and she stuck her finger somewhere and like ripped, like both of these fingers just ripped the skin off. It was like blood everywhere. We had no idea what to do. The security came and they like got somebody to like disinfect it, but the guy couldn't like bandage it or anything. Anyways, he told us to go to the hospital. And so lucky for us, right across the mall, there's a hospital. And so we went there. And then they like did an x-ray. Luckily she didn't break anything. It was just like a lot of like really deep cuts. And so they cleaned her up, they bandaged her, gave her medicine, whatever. We saw the doctor and everything was actually done by the doctor, most of it. And yeah, we ended up with a huge bill of $98. It's something, but we were like laughing about it because in Seattle, when I fell off my bike and I thought I broke a rib, I went to the hospital to get an x-ray. I paid $1,000 on top of the monthly payments that we do on insurance. And then when baby Victor was sick with the flu, we went to Children's Hospital. We paid $1,400 because they like, for what? Because they gave us, what do you call those, like popsicles or whatever, and had us give him the ibuprofen. Anyways, $98 for all of it. So that was painful. And then like for a whole week straight, we had to like clean her up and bandage her. We couldn't go to the beach, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, that was bad thing number one. Bad thing number two, just a couple days after that happened, Big Victor got sick. And so like throwing up, diarrhea, fever. And then it took him like 2 days to get better. And then literally as soon as he got better, Naya got sick. Throwing up, fever, diarrhea. And literally like the day that she got fine and she got better, I got sick. Lucky for me, it was just throwing up, but like I couldn't eat for 2 days. Today's the first day I'm eating. But in a way, you know, look at the bright side. I probably lost a couple pounds. So those were our 4 bad things, and that took a while. So sorry we were not in the condition to do updates. But also during that time, we've been busy and we have a lot of good stuff. So number one, we figured out our laundry situation. That was like a big problem the last time we talked. And so there's like a laundry place, like building next door. It costs about like $20 every time that we do the laundry, just because, I mean, it's 4 of us. But anyways, we'll deal with it for now. We'll be moving soon, hopefully. Anyways, good thing number 2 is we had our first visitor. My brother Daniel came to visit for a week. He loved it, although it was raining, so we couldn't do a lot of stuff for like a couple days while he was here. But he said he loved the food, the tacos were so good, the seafood. Anyways, he had a great time, and we had a great time with him being here. Good thing number 3 was New Year's Eve. We celebrated with Luis, who's actually from Seattle. He was here and he was kind enough to invite us to celebrate with his family. And it was actually pouring rain that night, but it was like the warm rain. So we were outside in the pouring rain, wearing jackets, but we weren't cold. And then the fireworks were the fireworks were right on the beach and we were standing right underneath them. And it was really fun. It was really cool. That was number 3. Good thing number 4 is we enrolled the kids in a great Montessori preschool. They're both going to the same school. It's got a cute little uniform. We'll put up pictures or take video. They start on Monday. There is like a huge list though of things that we need to buy, like, and to send them off with like glasses and cups and toothbrushes, and a kilo of plastic bags was requested. Anyways, we'll figure that out. Number five, shoot, I'm forgetting my list. What else? Oh, yeah, we found like a really beautiful apartment, which we're waiting to move into. And hopefully that's going to happen like on Sunday, Monday. We're waiting for them just to do like a couple repairs on the balcony, but it's like in this beautiful, secured community. And so we can't wait. We can't wait. It has a pool and it's close to the school. And yeah. Number six is actually where we are. So video. So this place is called La Isla de la Piedra. So this place is actually called La Isla de la Piedra. It's not an actual island, but it's like a peninsula, and it's my favorite place so far here in Mazatlan. I mean, as you can see, it's beautiful, and there's like so much stuff. Like, kids can go on pony rides, and adults can go on big horse rides, and we can like go swimming or just sit around, and the kids can run around, and it's really fun. Let's see, what else? Victor, is there anything else? What else am I forgetting? I think I said eight things, but I don't remember the other two, so they'll have to be in the next update. So anyways, we are alive, we're okay, we survived sickness, and hopefully starting next week we'll be in a new place, and the kids are going to school and things. Oh, I remembered, last night, like after almost a month, we finally went out salsa dancing. It was at this place called Life in Espanol. It was really fun. There wasn't a lot of dancing going on, and the DJ doesn't actually play salsa, only the band does, and the band most of the time actually plays, well, half the time plays cumbia, but they also play some bachata. Anyways, there's a lot of work to do here in Mazatlan for the salsa community to grow and for us to have like a social and actual salsa. Oh, and there's an iguana. So anyways,
you can hold the
Iguana. Yeah, here. Let's hold the iguana as I finish this video. Perfect ending. Where I'm supposed to do this?
Yes.
Okay. Uh-oh. They're Victor, Victor. Heavy. Anyways, Naya, say hi. Victo, say hi. Oh, they're saying hi to the iguana, not to you guys, sorry. Anyways, until next time, Shoko Manini. Goodbye from Mazatlan.
Manini.